Final Cut Pro to Motion and Back. Apple Motion is an animation program for creating effects that can be used as plugins for Final Cut Pro. And what I've found is that the first impression that most new Final Cut Pro beginners have of Motion is a sense of intimidation. And I'm here to soothe that sense of confusion with easy tutorials that show you how to use Motion without any hassles. And let me assure you, as a Final Cut Pro editor, you don't have to be a coding expert or a full-time animator to get real benefits from Motion. Just keep it simple and take it one step at a time. No need to get complex unless you want to. And then with the basics under your belt, you can then improve your knowledge. You'll be able to enhance your Final Cut Pro edits with the very first attempt at Motion, I promise you. My name's Bruce, and if we've met before, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe and press the bell so I can make more videos like this for you. In this series of tutorials, I'll concentrate on the synergy between Final Cut Pro and Apple's Motion application. And number one, I'll look at new Final Cut Pro plugins that can be created in Motion. In fact, all of the plugins that you see in Final Cut Pro have been made in Motion. And number two is I'll show you about transitions, effects, titles, and generators that are already within Final Cut Pro and can be modified by you for future use. This tutorial, though, is focusing on your first visit to Motion from within Final Cut Pro and doing a simple change in Motion and round-tripping back to Final Cut Pro. And as I've said before, I find that in learning Motion, it's best to keep it simple to start and then progress to more complex things when you've got the basics under your belt. But for this tutorial, I'll just be modifying a title that's supplied with Final Cut Pro. I'll change the default words, the font and the colours, but they'll still be modifiable in Final Cut Pro. Along the way, you'll see some of the ways to work in Motion. First in Final Cut Pro, I'll select titles at the top of the screen. I'll select Build In, Out from the sidebar. Select Dynamic Title. I'll hover over the title so you can see the effect of the three words, that's title, subtitle, and date. And if you don't see these, make sure that skimming is selected just above the effects browser. Right-click on Dynamic Title. You'll see an option, Open a Copy in Motion. An explanation, because this is an Apple-supplied plugin, you can't open the original plugin in Motion, as you can with third-party purchase plugins. And you can see here that you can open this original plugin from this non-Apple title. Note, some third-party plugins are protected and will not be able to be opened in Motion. Now with this dynamic title, I'll select Open the Copy in Motion. There'll be a few seconds delay while Motion launches. And if you haven't seen Motion before, I'll show you a little about the interface here. But for a more detailed look, check out the tutorial Get Started in Motion. Click the eye above. There are four main panels in the interface. Bottom right is the timeline, which is viewed at the top right in the project viewer. And as you move the playhead, the items show in the viewer. The items can be enabled and disabled with the ticks in the sidebar. Each item runs for a certain length in the timeline. And you can see that subtitle and its filters, those that affect the subtitle and are positioned below the subtitle, start at 67 seconds and end at 144 seconds. Also, because subtitle is selected in the timeline, it also shows in the mini timeline. In this case, subtitle is an asset, it's blue, and the filters that affect it are purple. When the asset, subtitle, is moved in the timeline, all of the filters are moved as well. But the filters can be moved independently, and when they're selected independently, you can see that they show in the MIDI timeline. When you select an asset in the timeline sidebar, it's also selected in the project sidebar above. This has got three tabs, but for this exercise here, I'm only going to use the Layers tab. And the final panel is on the far left. It can be populated with either the library or the inspector. The library shows everything that's included with Motion and can be added to projects. Music and Photos shows your iTunes on your computer or your Photos app from your computer. The inspector can be likened to the inspector in Final Cut Pro and has several tabs above that change to suit whatever part of the project you're working with at that time. In this tutorial, I'm only going to change the text and the colors so you can see how to round trip back to Final Cut Pro. Place the playhead over the title's red marker in the timeline. Select the bottom item in the sidebar, Title. Make sure the inspector is active and select the Text tab. Select Font and change to Helvetica Light Oblique. At the bottom, replace Title with My. And just above, make sure that the Editable in FCP is ticked. This means that all the options above can be modified in Final Cut Pro, and if it's unticked, whatever's selected here will be fixed and not able to be changed in Final Cut Pro. At the top of the inspector, you'll see the Format tab. It's blue. Select the Appearance tab, which now becomes blue. You'll now see the color options. Click on the white rectangle and the color wheels appear. Change to green. To ensure that the color can be changed in Final Cut Pro, select the downward chevron to the right of the word color and select Publish. Take a note for future reference. Any items that you want to be modifiable in Final Cut Pro will need to be published, except as you've seen, for format items where editable in FCP is ticked. It pays to be well organized in Motion. Always rename your assets so you know what they are when you come back to them again. Let's move back to the project sidebar and click and hold on the word title. Rename it to My. It changes in the timeline as well. Now select subtitle in the sidebar and change the color to red under the Appearance tab. Now change the font to Helvetica, Light Oblique, under the Format tab. Rename subtitle to Text Is. Ensure that Editable in Final Cut Pro is ticked. Change title to Text Is in the sidebar. Now do the same changes to Date, change the color to blue, and rename to Helvetica. There are some changes that need to be made to the links to the filters for the second and third text items. Select the link Face Color under the Text Is in the sidebar. Select Behaviors in the inspector and change the source object occurrences from My to Text Is. This also needs to be done for the other two links for Text Is. And also change the third text that's Helvetica in the same way. Now to round trip back to Final Cut Pro. Select Save As in the File menu. In the Template field, type Dynamic Helvetica. In the Category field, select Build In Out. Select Publish. Now we're in Final Cut Pro, you can select the titles and drag Dynamic Helvetica into the timeline. You can change the colors in the font, but the default is now a colored Helvetica font, not the impact font from the original Dynamic title. And as you see, Motion is a great support tool for Final Cut Pro, and you don't need to be an animation expert to get real results. I hope you found this information useful. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell so I can make further videos for you.